Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning stuff from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1658. Why is Excel autofilling my formulas? Today's question is sent in by Bob. Bob says, hey, I have a database today. It has information in US dollars, Great Britain pounds, euros, and Swiss francs. And he says, I created a new column to convert everything to pounds. And he said, here's what I did. I went to the drop down here and chose just US dollars. And I entered in my formula for equal 0.664 times the amount. And he says, it's flipping me out. This automatically filled down. And what's even worse is it didn't just fill down to the cells I could see, it filled down to all the cells. So my grand plan of being able to filter to just US dollars and put in a formula, and then another filter to CHF in a formula, and another filter to EUR and put in a formula, is not working at all. So I'm going to undo. All right, so you know, the first thing we want to do is immediately after it does that fill. Well, first, Bob, here's what's happening. Someone had went through and made this into an official table using home format as table or Ctrl+T, and that's why you're getting that behavior. All right, so that's why it's happening, and it doesn't happen most of the rest of the time. Times 0.664. As soon as you press enter, it fills down. Right then, you had to look for this little drop down here. It's called AutoCorrect Options. Open that drop down and say stop automatically creating calculated columns, and now you will be able to copy this down to the visible cells. Even I don't know if this is going to work. Let's see. Did it work? We'll go over to CHF instead of US dollars. Yeah, beautiful. Okay, then CHF is 0.705 times amount. Copy that down. And then switch over to euros, where the formula is 0.864 times, always start with an equal sign, right? Times the amount, copy that down, and okay, using that approach, you will be able to come up with all of your formulas that you're looking for. Now, we should have done GBP, which is just a copy over, right? Hang on. And after a few different filters, you now have your column that has great GBP, and everything is good, right? So this was the question that Bob asked. Why is this happening? Why is the formula autocomplete happening? And how do I turn it off? The other method to have turned it off is once you're inside the formula, once you're inside the table, come over here to Table Tools Design, and there's something called Convert to Range, and that will turn that feature off permanently. For this data set, although Bob said that someone else set this up. So when this goes back to the person who set it up, they're going to be hacked off that we converted it back to a range. But maybe he's never sending it back, and then, you know, screw those people. We're going to just convert to range. Yes, right? And now we can do things either way. All right, so, you know, when we started out the podcast, we used Don't Fear the Spreadsheet. That's your sign that this is a podcast episode that is designed for beginners. I'm sure a lot of you who are regulars to the podcast are out there screaming that there is a much, much better way to go. And I agree with you, there is a much better way to go, but I didn't want to overwhelm Bob today. We'll overwhelm Bob tomorrow. So stop back for tomorrow's episode, 1659, and I'll show you a great way that we can leave that formula autocomplete on, because we're going to write one formula that solves the problem for every single currency. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.